Hey, good morning. I'm here on Bill Street at the Elvis Presley statue. And I'm going to Graceland today. It's my first trip that I'll be making to Graceland. I really can't wait. I'm going today at 2. I have driven past there and looked onto the property and looked at the airplanes. I've been an Elvis fan for so long that I don't remember when it happened that I became an Elvis fan. I do remember exactly where I was and what I was doing when he died. My father was retiring from the military. We had moved out of our government housing and we were in a temporary housing, which any dependent of a non-commissioned officer will tell you, when you're getting out of the military, everything's pretty much bare bones when you're transitioning out. It's a lot of hurry up and wait with minimal supplies. So I was already sad enough because I didn't want to leave where we were again. And then Elvis Presley died. This was in August 1977, as you all know. The problem is that 45 years have passed and Elvis has gained more fans than when he was alive. Now there's this movie out, which that's going to cause him to get even more fans. And the problem with these powerful movie people such as Tom Hanks, Baz Luhrmann, his fans, his current fans, some of his older fans, a lot of you people are liars. You're professional liars. You do mental gymnastics that allow you to say things about Elvis and believe things about Elvis that, number one, aren't true. Number two, he never believed in. And three, he never said. He actually typically said the opposite of what a lot of you idiots are saying. And I do mean to offend you. The other problem is how you're portraying Tom Parker. Elvis did not just do a 180 on the day that he met Tom Parker and start singing and dancing the way he sang and he danced. And as you know, as he got older, his voice got stronger. Elvis wasn't living at Graceland in 1953 and 1954. His wealth and the global icon, the superstardom, did not happen with any of the American men, and especially, well, you know, the men that I'm talking about, you really want to know the truth. These are American white males in the entertainment industry, and none of them took Elvis out of the South. That was Tom Parker, non-American citizen of, I guess, the Netherlands or Holland. What does it matter?
Head east on Beale Street towards South November 6th.
Tell the truth, for example, of the conditions that Gladys, Vernon, and Elvis found themselves, where they are victims of discrimination. And you want to call it, it's basically finance-based racism. And the person that corrected all of that, who kicked the door down and brought Elvis out of the South and introduced him to the world, that was Tom Parker. But you ain't got nothing good to say about that man, because he came through here and he wrecked your system. Jim Crow. Segregation. And then you managed to take the things that racist white people were saying about Elvis Presley and attribute to him. And now we've got stupid ass black people claiming Elvis Presley. The man that put a black female group on a global stage, had them opening for him and touring with him, the man that shared a global stage with one of the greatest flute players we've ever heard in our life. And you call him racist, you call him, you say these nasty things about him. You know, I'm not trying to change history that or change your mind or your heart, but you gotta stop lying. Because every time I hear Elvis talk about stars that came after him, he used the word better. Elvis said that. Elvis wasn't a racist, and Tom Parker was not this stupid ass imp that this dumbass Tom Hanks portrayed him as in this movie. This movie, it does Tom Parker a serious disservice by portraying him as some impish freaking devil. Tom Parker was exactly what was needed to face down Jim Crow and segregation that existed in the South. If you don't like it, fuck you. You don't like him, fuck you twice. You can lie all you want. Say what you want. Elvis can't cuss you out, but I sure can. You're a bunch of dumbasses. Tom Parker was the type of person that took steps to make sure that kids that were rampaging at Elvis's concerts did not get hurt. And that's been reduced to Tom Hanks talking like some imp that's coming from the gates of Mordor. And it's sad.